with you at Proactive Investors London, and we're in the property space now. We're talking to our Proactive analyst, Ed Stacey, who's going to give us a research note on Custodian REIT. They are the commercial property landlords, of course, Proactive Investors viewers will know, and their quarterly report is out. Ed, what can we see in the report?
Well, the big highlight for us was the dividend that they've declared. They've increased it for the quarter by 19% compared to the previous quarter. And the shares now at that run rate are yielding 5.5% dividend yield per year. And that's important because, you know, Custodian is an income-focused commercial property landlord. It's all about rental income and paying a dividend to the shareholder. Now, like a lot of names in the commercial property space, Custodian rebased their dividend during 2020. This was in April, so, you know, at the outset of the COVID crisis, with tenants being offered the chance by the government to take rent holidays and this sort of thing. They rebased the dividend, but unlike some of the peers, what Custodian did was quite emphatically sort of declare a floor under the dividend, a minimum level that they wanted to keep paying. And then from that minimum level that they set in April last year, in successive quarters now, they've actually been increasing the dividend back upwards and doing that now in spite of the fact we still have lockdowns going on. So it's a good show of confidence in that rental income. And when we finally look at that, you know, the report for the last quarter, what's driven that confidence in the dividend? Well, the company's reported that rent collection for the quarter ran at 96%. So the tenants are paying their rent. And so they've got the confidence in the cash flows. And so in spite of the fact that lockdowns are not over yet, the company's been able to declare an increased dividend for the quarter and set its targets for the next quarter and for the next financial year. So it's a good show of confidence in that dividend now from Custodian.
Interesting, isn't it? It's a resilience story, really. Custodian REIT, of course, been players in the market for a long time. But for them to sit in the space and differentiate themselves so much by that healthy-looking dividend really is quite remarkable, isn't it, from an analyst point of view?
Yeah, well, as we look around the sector, obviously there are names in the commercial property space who are suffering rather more distress. When we look at the things that do differentiate Custodian, I mean, the first obvious thing is just don't have too much gearing on the balance sheet. They've got a loan to value ratio of 24%. So they've gone into all this not over leveraged, and that always helps. The other thing is just looking at the types of property that they own. It's a diverse portfolio with a lot of industrial and logistics properties, offices in out of town, edge of town business parks, not city center offices. And those industrial properties we're talking spread around all over the country. And what they don't have is a lot of high street retail. That's down to 10% now of the portfolio. High street retail, obviously a difficult space. They're not overexposed to that. So it's a good property mix and a good diverse mix. And that's given them resilience during the last 12 months. I also think it makes them well-placed for the post-COVID environment. I think these more out-of-town business park type offices, for example, are going to be more of a trend going forward. So resilience and also well-placed going forward.
Pretty smart, isn't it, to get out of the high street and into logistics. Logistics keeping us all going at the moment, I think. Let's talk a little bit more about that 5.5% dividend story, a healthy dividend, I think is how you described it. How does that impact on the share story? What's the story there? Is there an upside?
Yes, I mean, I think the dividend can be a driver for the share price. As the market starts to get more comfortable in this dividend and the trajectory, the recovery trajectory of the dividend, you look at that 5.5% dividend yield. That's a very healthy income yield for the shareholder. And I think people are going to look at that and say, actually, it's too high a yield for this kind of quality of income. And if you were to put the shares on a 4% dividend yield, that would mean the share price now should be 125. I'm not saying that's a price target, but just I would invite investors to think about what's the right kind of dividend yield for this kind of quality of dividend. And you're going to be thinking of a share price that's some way north of the current share price. So yes, there is definitely a potential for a capital gain as well as carry on getting this dividend.
So looking forward then to 21-22, really interesting one to keep your eye on then, Custodian REIT.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, expect this dividend to be sustained and then to keep increasing going forwards and expect the tenant base to keep showing good resilience. I think in the post-COVID world, these out-of-town offices and continuing the focus on industrial and logistics, these are good places to be positioned.
Ed Stacey, always good to talk to you. Ed Stacey's full research note is, of course, available if you click the I in the corner of your screen. But for the moment, Ed, thanks very much indeed.
Thank you.